Yo, what's going on, you absolute fucking beauty? So today I want to talk about whether or not you should be dirty bulking or lean bulking. And if you don't know what that even means, I'll explain that. I get this question all the fucking time, so I want to clear it up. There is a clear favorite I have because I've been through both of these, and let's just say like one of them is just a lot better. Okay, so first let's like define a dirty bulk. The way I see it is you don't really have a calorie limit. You just kind of eat whatever the fuck you want and you try and stuff your face. Like you eat till you're full all the time. That's pretty much how I see dirty bulk, okay? It's not just the same as just eating until you're satisfied. It's eating till you're really, really full. Like you keep stuffing your face. You have no calorie goal. You could be in an 1,000 calorie surplus, 2,000 calorie surplus. You're not really tracking. Like most people don't track in a dirty bulk. And I kind of see a dirty bulk as an excuse to just eat everything in sight and eat like shit and just kind of get fat. Like the good thing about a dirty bulk, I'd say, is your strength will probably skyrocket because it's not that you're putting on so much more muscle, it's that you're putting on so much weight. It's fat as well. You're putting on a lot of fat. So if you're weighing more, you're gonna move more weight. Like think about this. If someone, you probably know some guy who's just, you know, naturally kind of bigger. Maybe he's like 6 foot, he's just like 200 pounds. Just, he's not ripped, but he's just like big, like thick. You know how powerlifters look? Some guys just have really good genetics and they're really big in high school or whatever. And he could probably go up to the bench press and bench press a pretty good weight without even ever training for it when you couldn't do that. That's just because they're bigger, like they weigh more. So if you weigh more, you're probably gonna push more weight. It doesn't always work like that, but there's a strong correlation between how much someone weighs and how much weight they can push. That's why there's weight classes for powerlifting and whatnot. And also the good thing about a dirty bulk is your relationship with food is just really good. Like you just eat anything you want. You have no calorie goal. You're not tracking. You're just eating literally everything you desire. You're eating a cheesecake. You're eating a pizza. I mean, it's not the healthiest way to go, but you're just like, your mind is not focused on food all the time. It shouldn't be anyway. If it is, then you're not really in that much of a surplus. Because if you're in a massive surplus, your mind shouldn't be food focused. Unless you're like wanting to get the calories in, of course. But I mean food focused in the sense where like, fuck, I need to eat right now. You'll probably be so full where you don't even want your next meal. So your relationship with food is pretty fucking good. And you just get to eat some really nice shit. Now, the downsides to a dirty bulk. You become literally a fat piece of shit. Your face gets bloated. Not good if you're in university or high school or whatever, trying to get girls and shit. Like, come on, no girl likes a bloated face and just a fat piece of shit. Like, you just get fat. You get so fat. You gain so much fat. It's not even, like, close to the amount of muscle you gain. Like, the ratio is way off. You're gaining, like, for every 1 pound of muscle, you're gaining like 4 pounds of fat. That's literally how it's going. Everyone thinks like half of it's gonna be muscle. No, it's mostly fat and water. A lot. You gain a ton of water. Like you could put on an extra 10 pounds of water weight just because you're full of water. You're full of glycogen all the time. So when you cut down, you might notice like in the first week, you lose 5 pounds. It's not fat, that's water because you were holding on to so much during that dirty bulk. You're just fucking a bloated whale. Also, from my personal experience, because I'm just coming off of like, I don't know, I'd say a 2 year bulk with maybe a little cut in between, but like it was a 2 year kind of dirty bulk. I was really, really big, like fat for like 2 years. And when you're that weight, when you keep putting on weight like that, you don't seem to notice like in your head. Like I did not notice I was that fat. I didn't think I was that fat. Now looking back at photos, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck? Who's letting me walk around like that? It's like a really mental shift, mental game. Like my face, if you go look back on some of my old TikToks or even one of my first YouTube videos or whatever, like it was so much bigger than it is now. Just screenshot me and then go look at the other one. So for me, I gained quite a bit of muscle, like quite a bit of muscle as a natural. I'm not on steroids or anything, so. You know, there's only so much you can gain as a natty. I did gain a ton of strength. My strength really, really went up because I had so much weight. And I haven't actually lost too much strength because I've been cutting for around 5 months now. And I haven't lost too much, maybe a little bit, because I was, what, 222? And now I'm 184. So I did lose a little bit of strength, but I'm going to correlate that to the literal weight loss, the fat loss. You're gonna lose some strength if you lose, like, I don't know, almost 40 pounds. You're gonna lose some strength. There's just nothing you can do. It doesn't mean you necessarily lost a ton of muscle, because my strength is relatively similar, like off by a few reps on bench press or whatever. But you're gonna lose some strength if you lose quite a bit of weight. It's just inevitable. When I was dirty bulking though, I literally just kind of started feeling like shit. The first like little bit was really, really nice. Like I was just eating everything. I was just no limits. I'd go to get Uber Eats, get a Domino's, go out to eat all the time. It was so nice. Just said yes to everything because my appetite is massive. If you have a big appetite, dirty bulking, it's really nice because you just eat everything. It's kind of just an excuse to get fat. Like I said, it's just an excuse to eat everything. And I'm in university, right? So we're drinking a lot of alcohol, which has a ton of calories. I didn't say no to any shots, didn't say no to any beers, didn't say no to the Domino's pizza after the bar, just yes to everything. So I guess it was good in that sense, but I just got so fucking fat. Like, it just, not good. Like, I was just way too fat. Looking back, I'm disgusted at the way I was looking. Like, looking at yourself in the mirror every single day, you're not really gonna see any changes. It's just a mental face fuck. It just happens. Like, even when you're putting on weight versus when losing weight, same thing. Like, you won't really see daily or even weekly changes, especially when you're putting on weight. And I wasn't weighing myself at all. Like, I would weigh myself maybe once every 3 weeks or something. I didn't really care. I was just like, fuck it, I'll put on as much weight as I can. I'll try and get as heavy as I can. And I have the biggest appetite. So I literally didn't plateau because I could keep eating. Like, a lot of people will plateau, not me. I have a really, really big appetite. I'm not just saying that, it's true. I've always been able to eat. Ask my fucking mom, ask my friends. They know me and my brother can really, really eat a ton of food, okay? And I could just never stop. I never got full. Like, I'd still get full sometimes, but I wouldn't get full like some other people would. Some people would just be like plateauing at, let's say, 200 pounds, but I would just keep gaining, because I can keep eating. Now let's talk about a lean bulk. A lean bulk is where you're pretty aware of your calories. You're in a small calorie surplus. Keyword, small. You're in like a 200 to, I'd say, 400 calorie surplus, so you're 200, 400 calories above your maintenance. If my maintenance was 2,500, I would eat around, let's say, 2,900 calories. That would be a lean bulk for me. And what this is gonna do is put you in a calorie surplus, so you're getting enough energy to fuel training and fuel muscle growth, or make it optimal to grow muscle. But you're not in like this massive calorie surplus where you're gonna be putting on so much extra fat. You may put on a little bit, but it's not gonna be nearly as much as if you weren't tracking and you were in this huge calorie surplus. It's gonna be kind of limited. You're gonna gain quite a bit of muscle, probably the same amount of muscle you would on a dirty bulk, but without the fat gain. You're gonna gain some fat, but it's just nothing compared to the dirty bulk. Maybe a few pounds. You might notice it a little bit, but it's not gonna be like, oh my God, I got fat. Like, no one would really notice this fat gain on you if you do a proper lean bulk. But on a dirty bulk, people are gonna fucking notice your face getting fat and shit. But when I was, when I did a lean bulk, I noticed, like, you have to be kind of aware of your calories. You kind of gotta track your calories a little bit, like maybe not weigh everything out, because I don't recommend weighing your food out 24/7, 365 days a week. But when you're cutting, you should probably be weighing your food out because you need to be in a deficit. But when you're in a small surplus, you know, there's some variability. Just make sure you're roughly in a 200, 300 calorie surplus. But when you're doing a dirty bulk, you just don't track at all. So that's kind of the downside, I guess, to a lean bulk. You got to be more aware of your calories. You can't really just say yes to everything. You can definitely fit in anything, and you kind of have a lot of wiggle room because you're in a little bit of a surplus, but you're not in so much of a surplus where you can just like binge eat a cheesecake or a pizza after the bar every single night, maybe one night a week, but not like four like I was doing on my fucking dirty bulk. Also, during a lean bulk, you really have good sessions because you don't feel like a bloated whale and you're not stuffed to the brim all the time. So you really have good sessions. You have that little extra amount of calories to help push you a little farther and gain a little bit more muscle. If you're in a surplus, you are optimizing muscle growth. Yes, you can grow muscle at maintenance and in a deficit, but it is not optimal. Just because you can do something doesn't mean it's the best way, okay? I could go on another video on this. Greg Doucette keeps talking about main gaining, and that's a decent approach, but being in a small surplus is definitely better than being at maintenance if you want to grow the most amount of muscle possible and keep it after your cut. He keeps saying you're gonna lose all this muscle after your cut. You won't if you do it properly, if you don't get fat anyway. But as a lean, in a lean bulk, your sessions will be a lot better than if you were in a freaking dirty bulk. full of water and bloated. When you're in a small surplus, you're optimizing muscle growth. Like, you're gonna gain the exact same amount of muscle you would when you're in a dirty bulk. In a dirty bulk, you might gain a little more strength because you're gaining a ton of weight, but studies have shown that muscle growth is the same if you're in a little small surplus or if you're in like a 2,000 calorie surplus, okay? If you're in that much of a surplus, you're just putting on extra fat, and maybe that's helping you push some more weight around, but it doesn't necessarily mean you're building more muscle. So, what would I recommend you do? Definitely a lean bulk. Okay, definitely 100% go with a lean bulk. The dirty bulk was just not worth it. I just became a complete fat ass. Didn't even like the way I looked. My face was way too fat. Just probably wasn't worth it in the end. And I probably wouldn't have gained any more muscle during this during my dirty bulk than I would if I was just in a small surplus. And I would have stayed pretty lean. My face wouldn't have been so fat. I just probably would have felt better. And you know, I'm in university. You want to look good all the time and shit. And I regret getting fucking to that stage. Jesus, nobody do that. Like, just, there's no point in getting that fat. Just stay lean, you'll look better, you'll feel better, and you'll put on the exact same amount of muscle. Hope I gave you guys some value out of this. If you notice, merch is coming in. These are just samples, but calories are fucking king, baby. So merch is coming in. I'm gonna have a merch update, put it on TikTok, YouTube, and Instagram. Just getting in samples. I want to ensure quality and all that good stuff. But I'm gonna have a launch date probably within the next 2 weeks, I'm hoping, if these samples fucking hurry up. But the merch is gonna be sick. Really, really good quality. Like, the fit is really good. I'll go over it in more detail because you guys probably follow me on TikTok and Instagram. If you're not, then fucking get on it. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.